This presentation is about the National Science Olympiad B Division Astronomy event, which this year is on the solar system, specifically on planetary science. So this is the content for the 2014 competition in Orlando, Florida, next May. I am Donna Young. I work with the Chandra X-ray Public Outreach Office in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and it has supported both the astronomy event and this event since 1999. I am the National Event Supervisor for the astronomy event. I am not the National Event Supervisor for this event. That's Dusty Schroeder, for those of you who know him. He used to be my co-event supervisor, but now he is the National Event Supervisor for the B Division astronomy event. And, the event this year, of course, this is the first time. We're all under a handicap here because nobody knows what the event's really going to look like, because this is the very first year since Dusty took over as National Event Supervisor that we've rotated into the solar system topics. So there is no previous prior event that you can download to use as a study guide. So we're all starting from scratch here. But if you have done Reach for the Stars within this year or last year, then you have an idea of how Dusty constructs his events. AAVSO also supports this event. If you go to the AAVSO website and look under Variable Stars, you'll see a section on Science Olympiad. And in that section, you will see that we post not only, we post all of the events, so this particular event for 2014 will be posted on the on this site. As I said, the previous couple of years are already posted on the site, but they will not be useful for you since we have a content change this year. But this webinar will also be linked from this site, and this PowerPoint presentation will be posted on this site if you want to just use it as a PowerPoint, if you are a coach or if you are a national events, if you are a regional or a state event supervisor. The parameters have not changed. Emphasis this year, though, is an understanding and knowledge of the properties and evolution of extraterrestrial ice and water in the solar system. Okay, extraterrestrial ice and water in the solar system. You can still bring two pages, 2 8.5 by 11 pieces of paper written on both sides with information from any source written on them. The one thing that is different this year, in the two prior years when it was Reach for the Stars, since there was a lot of identification that went on in the first part of the event, you could only use your notes for part two. So this year you can use your notes for all parts of the event. So here is the event description for the 2014 event. You may be asked to identify planets, moons, and features from this list as they appear on maps or any kind of imagery, and you must be knowledgeable, and this is what's most important, the history and the processes involved with ice and water on these particular objects. Okay, we're not looking at places like in the craters of the moon where there's some water here and there, because there's never been any significant amount of water flowing over the surface or under the surface of the moon that would form any particular features. And that's what we are interested in this year, for you to be knowledgeable about the history and the processes of water and ice as it formed these particular features. Emphasizing the ones that Dusty has selected for this year's event. So we have Mars, the north and the south polar caps, the equatorial glaciers, the permafrost. Those are the foremost. Emphasis is on those. And Europa. In Europa, you're interested in the Thrace and Thera macula, the Connemara chaos, the ridges, the cycloids, the plains, and the ocean. Then we have Enceladus, one of the satellites of Saturn, interested in the plumes and the jets and the tiger stripes. Then two more moons of Saturn. So we have three moons of Saturn represented this year. We have Iapetus and Titan. And then there is Triton, a moon of Neptune, and Ceres. And also comets and the Kuiper belt and the Oort cloud. Now, it says that you will also be asked to complete one or more hands-on or interpretive tasks selected from these following topics. But if you look at these topics and study them, they're all really interrelated, and I wouldn't expect to see a question involving just one of them. There is going to be pieces and parts from everything put into each one of these interpretive tasks, because you really cannot separate them out. The history and the process of formation of specific features, namely the ones that are listed above. The use of remote sensing, imagery, and satellite measurements of objects and features. Very important, because of course every single image I'm going to show you is the result of remote sensing. The physical, thermal, and chemical properties of potential habitats for life. There is a reason that we're interested in water in the solar system. And past, current, and planned future missions to explore these objects. For some of these objects, there's an awful lot of missions, and for some of them, there's like one, so we will see.